Okay, hey, we're out here in the Dodge Charger right now, this 2014 RT, with the first series of Uconnects that are out there. There was two listed updates for my Uconnect series, and that was basically discovered by putting the VIN number in the Uconnect website, where it basically asked for the VIN, and it'll decide what system came with your car. Now, with that in mind, also, if your radio has been swapped out or upgraded, it's very possible this might not match up with your firmware. So do some research if you're a second owner of the vehicle, and just double check that the radio has not been swapped out to the best of your ability. Anyways, so we're going to go ahead and upgrade the firmware on here. Now, I have upgraded this one in the last several years. With that being in mind, the website shows two. This is going to be on the first thumb drive. I'm going to give it a shot and see what the numbers reflect on the Uconnect system, as well as the firmware that's in this. And it'll tell us by going through the process. Now, all we have to do is select your keyless entry to the run position, but keep your foot off the brake. You're not starting the car. You just want to go to the run position. With this in mind, make sure all your media is out of their ports. I'm going to go ahead and plug in the USB drive. Now, it'll automatically detect. I had my radio on. It says, please do not turn off your vehicle during the software update. Let's go ahead and close this door real quick because of the sound chime. Okay, so anyways, there is the old one. There is the new update. So the first update I have going on is going to go ahead and update this to a newer version. We're going to repeat the process for the second update a little later. So let's go ahead and press yes. Checking data, please wait. This is going to go on for a minute or so, so I'm going to go ahead and pause here. Okay, second stage is starting within that minute's time frame. We are reflashing the Uconnect now. This is transferring files. So this is going to take a few minutes. While this is going on, like I said, this was the first update. Now, I have updated my system in the last 2 years of ownership, and I've had this car 3 years this last month. And with that in mind, when I did check for the updates, for some reason, it had the previous one that I had updated already in 2014 not listed as one of my updates. So that being said, I'm not sure if it selected my VIN and kept that in memory on the Uconnect site. But any which way, I'm going through the firmware updates as 1 and 2. I'm not jumping to 2 right away. This being said, that way I have a way to scale back if needed, and I can see if one update has an issue as opposed to the other update, so we'll find out. And I think the second update might include Siri, which will make my son very happy, but I'm not an Apple user myself, so. And my son is not old enough to drive, so he has no say-so in the vehicle. We're going to go ahead and pause here and come right back. Okay, now as you can hear, my climate control has started itself back up. It's resetting. I took the liberty of rolling the windows down, and I probably shouldn't have used any of the system, but it was like 100 degrees in the car and I was melting, so make sure you roll down the windows before you do this. Anyways, as it's reflashing through the last parts of the stages here, I can hear different things starting to reset, like the climate control, the blower box actuators closed up now. I can feel the heat starting. It was cool a minute ago, so I'm not sure if it's just going through a cycle or what, but possibly might fix and resolve the issues I have with my heated seats and all that, because like I had mentioned once before in a brief moment of one of my videos, my HVAC system has been fluky since my last flash at the dealership, which was last summer. During the wintertime, it acted like it was summertime, and during the summertime here,
even though the proper degrees show at the top temperature, it was acting like it was in the middle of winter time. Like, I can put the heated seats on now longer than I could in the winter time. It would just like shut off because it was getting too hot or something like that. But they would act flaky too, so maybe this might resolve it. We'll see. Okay, now we get the reflash is successful. Please touch after the screen HU reboots. Okay, I'm gonna do that with this hand because my other one's in the sling. Failed to mention I had a bicep surgery 2 days ago, so. Alright, so we get the accept law, blah 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 blah, error on reflashing. Please touch. That's not good. Okay, so we got an error on reflashing. What does that mean? And my climate control is going fucking haywire. Everything's on. So we're gonna shut off, open the door here, re-register, and start and run. See what happens. Accept. Okay, climate control. We're not set on automatic, but it is on AC. Let's sync these together. Okay. Let's see something. Sport mode is on. Okay, that works. Heated seat. We'll pray tell if this works. And it is the summertime, so it's still rocking. Oh, see her shut off quick. Heated wheel. I have that normally. Screen off. Okay.
We'll travel. All right. Restart it up. And that finishes the flashing of the...
Wow, that blows more. Okay. So it recalibrated my fans. Because that is powerful. Doesn't let my wife stay on though. We'll find out about that. Could be a number of things. Everything else looks fine. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna shut the car off, go back into AC mode. We're gonna hit these three buttons again: hot, cold, and defrost. Get to the dealer mode. Dealer mode. We're back into radio part info, and we should see 16, 21, D7. There we go, guys. So anyways, that's how you flash the firmware on the Uconnect, and that pretty much goes and follows suit pretty much for all of them. The newer Uconnect 2s, you can do it by Wi-Fi as well from the dealership. They have a system set up to do that, but I still do not like it. You lose data packets. Just have a hardwired USB drive, you know, ready to go. This one here is, I think, 8 gigabytes, and that was fine enough. You can go 4 gigabytes max. But anyways, after the update's all done, you know, run through all your user info and see if it's working and all that. This is supposed to include Siri of some sort, but I'm not too concerned. A little later, but as of right now, the main purpose was to get the firmware updated. So, hey, thanks for watching Tech Review by Irdi.